Long live the king, you a king, you know it. King already, already, you know it. Top everything, everything, you know it. King already, already, you know it. My body so got a king body. Body gon' shine, bling, bling body. Calling all the shots, ring, ring body. Crown on your head. Hey Royals, welcome to my YouTube channel. Nah, this ain't working. Hey Royals, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're subscribed, thank you, love. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't subscribed as yet, what's the hold up? Today I'm going to be doing a story time about how I almost lost my life, okay? This is a real true story. Some might find it funny, some might be concerned, but it's 2 years ago and yeah, it's nothing to be worried about now. Well, I'll just get into it. When, you could say around 2018, 2019-ish, I used to work at a gas station, yeah? While working at the gas station, it has this university back home. It's WAS University. It's basically where, like, people from all over Taiwan, America and stuff come to that university. So it had this specific WAS student who used to always come at the gas station like 3 times a week to fill up his ATV bike. He used to try and talk to me and what's that and what's not. You know, I always wanted like my own transportation, right? But I don't have a driver's license. And I just thought like having an ATV bike would have been like the simpler thing to do, or you know, easier to manage. It had this day now, I was finishing work and that was actually my last customer. So I was there talking to the young man. I was like, one of these days, let me drive on your ATV. I'm a professional.
Stop the cap.
I drive only standard.
Lying so much.
Automatic would be like a to me.
God, you're a liar.
Lies. You get me? I never ever drove one yet in my life. He had the same. I was finishing, like when I was leaving from work, he came. He was the last customer I dealt with actually. And then I was telling him, you know, one of these days you should let me drive your ATV. He was like, okay, then I'll wait until you finish signing off and all that, and then we can go for a spin. Well, you look now, we went to this road. It barely used. If you're from St. Kitts, you know you have Delta gas station. It has like a trucking thingy.
What?
Besides Delta gas station, you have the Chinese supermarket, and then you have this like abandoned road between Rams and the Chinese supermarket, I think. Yeah, that's where people got to learn to drive and all those stuff. So we went behind there.
Cooling.
Driving. He was like showing me like you know, the basic thing, because it was like semi-automatic or automatic or something like that. Telling me about the problem, but I didn't really study about that. And I'll bear in mind, this is the first time, me. That's why what happened to me, it suit me. When I come to think about it, it really do suit me, because it's my first time. The young man trying to explain to me, like, okay, then the bike have a problem, this and that. I was just concerned about getting on the ATV and riding the ATV so I could know how to ride the ATV for when I get my own ATV. You understand? Because you didn't need a license to get on an ATV. And I was just thinking about, yeah, an ATV. Female, yeah. Watch me. 869, bike life. Yeah. But, yeah, so then I went on it. I did as he said. And I did a couple spins, yeah, slowly, and it was perfect, you get me? But then my head start to swell. I get on the ATV, I going fast. Well, I wasn't really going fast yet, but I think I did got confident in myself to feel like I was a pro for the 2 times I went round the roundabout.
Oh, stupid.
So I told the young man, I was like, record me. You know what I mean? Yeah, record me. Guys, watch. Watch again. watch one more time. Well, to be honest, after I fell, right, I felt nothing. Like the fear, I don't know if it's just like it just happened at the time, but to how I was suffering, like when I was coming down, I was like, damn man, you're gonna go dead. And then when I realized, man, dead, I ain't feel nothing. I wish the video did show how I get back up. Then my jump back up, skirt rip, cuts all over. I have so much, I get so much scars from this. This was a scar. Oh Lord, my foot ashy. I can't even show. You thought. But yeah, I had scars all over. If you watch properly in the video, you see like a pong on the concrete. It wasn't my head. Thank God it wasn't my head. A pong, my neck. Like here. Here is where it hit the concrete, really. You understand? So a pong, my neck. And sis jumped back up happy. She ain't dead. So I ain't feel nothing. My skirt ripped. The young man drive me main road with my skirt rip. I a panty shine. Sean ain't even know. Sean not gonna know. Panty shine, everything. I had to go up Shadwell by my friend. She makes clothes and stuff like that. I had to go Shadwell, go beg Toysha to make a skirt. Well, give me a skirt. Because it was just revealing. And then I was in town from there to Shadwell, and then driving to Shadwell with all the boys, and was devastating. Yeah, Tasha had to give me a skirt to drive to continue my journey home. You understand? Skirt rip up, skin scrub up, and oil. Bear in mind, even though I just get it fall and I gone back on the bike to go on this journey, I ain't feeling nothing, like no pain, nothing. I reach home, I tell mommy, mommy, you know, I just fall off a bike, you know. Nothing, just the cuts, them bear look disgusting, and that's it. I sent my video to two friends. Two. I sent the video to, when I fall off the bike, to my two friends. The young people them make me video went very well. Showing a shame to the dogs. Mommy was shame. Mommy call me. Somebody saw the video, yeah. Mommy said, Diamond! Because I get it falling, you know, but to how I acting, she wouldn't think it was a serious fall, you know. She's like, Diamond was sitting on the bike, eh? All kind of memes. Wait for it. We had one talking about fell in your man bed, like all sorts of different memes, all sorts of stuff came out of this video. And I ain't gonna lie, I was laughing to it until the night, guys. I went in my bed, yeah, laying down, you know, main beard, nothing. It was like after I finished that, I was just on my phone cussing the friends them who made my video go viral, watching everybody laugh at me and everything. So I lay down going through the phone. When it's time, when I do this, I ain't getting up at all. It's like after my body get relaxed, the pain just come on. The pain just come on. And then out of nowhere, this big thing like this. My head has to be so pain for days. My body, the cramp up. I was just laying on the bed, and the tears was just flowing. Everything to come down on me. I couldn't get dressed. My little brother had to dress me. My little brother had to look for shoes. And while he doing that, he cussing me. But hey, nobody send you on a bike, you. But hey, where I got to do this? Mommy, nobody send you on a bike, you. all kind of thing. Yeah, had to dress me, had to put on my clothes, had to, I couldn't move. Yeah, it took me 2 brothers to take me out of the bed. I could not have moved. I was in so much pain, so much pain. All over was aching. You get me? Went to the hospital, and the doctor was like, so why did it take so long to come if you fall off the bike 12 o'clock in the afternoon? I said, sir. And it was a man doctor. You know, I ain't even gonna say what I was. Because I'm not homophobic, you know? I don't want to come off as homophobic. But yeah, he was nice at all. He was nice. He didn't do nothing. He rubbed some things on my cut. Give me paracetamol and sent me home. So almost for a whole week, I wasn't working. I was just sick. Sick. And yes, that's the story time of when I almost lost my life. Because you see, when I was driving down on the bike, right, that's the main road there. So if that bike didn't screw off, I would have gone on in the main road and I would have lost my life.